Cooking is not possible without heat. It's all about how heat entered in the food and what happened to food. This process of cooking or heating food is possible due to heat transfer. So this video focuses on how the heat is transferred in cooking. Hello friends, I'm Naveen Chahal, welcomes you all on Hospitality Broadcast. Heat transfer refers to an exchange of thermal energy between two objects. Heat naturally moves from hot surface to cooler surface. The rate of heat transfer depends upon the temperature of each surface and the medium through which heat is transferred. This movement of heat is commonly known as heat transfer. In cooking, cooking appliances such as gas burner, fryer, microwave, or oven works as a heat source which transfers heat to food. Heat transfer helps in cooking the food. During heat transfer, potentially harmful bacteria and other microorganisms are destroyed. It not only makes the food safe to eat, but also easy to digest. Now let's talk about different forms of heat transfer. The heat could be transferred in three ways: conduction, convection, radiation. In conduction, heat is transferred within or between the objects due to the transfer of heat by molecules vibrating at their mean position. For transferring the heat from one object to another, they must be in direct contact. Let's take an example of cooking pan over a burner or any other heating source. Conduction usually occurs in solids where molecules are held together by intermolecular force of attraction. Once molecules receive heat energy, they start vibrating about their mean position. These molecules then bump into surrounding particles and transfer some of their energy to them. This process of heat transfer happens from hot end down to the cooler end of the substance. The heat energy of burner is conducted to the bottom of a pan sitting on top of it. From there, pan conducts heat energy to its contents. The food in a pan is cooked from outside in. Cooking utensils are usually made from metals, mainly iron, steel, stainless steel, aluminium, or copper. Metals are a good and efficient conductor of heat. Cooking utensils need to have a well-made flat and strong base so that the heat is evenly conducted through its base. Even if base is too thin, heat will not be transferred evenly. You cannot use wood, plastic, cotton, wool, etc. for cooking as they are bad conductor of heat. These are called heat insulators. But you can use heat insulator in a variety of ways to prevent us from burning ourselves when we are cooking. That's why handles are made up of plastic or wood so that you can hold it comfortably. Some pans also use hollow metal handles as the air inside it works as a heat insulator. Remember, in the heat transfer process, there is no transfer of matter from one location to another. Only heat energy is transferred from one molecule to another without changing their position. But opposite to this, in convection method, heat is transferred with the actual motion of matter from one place to another within the body. This mode of transfer occurs mostly in liquid and gases. The convection is also of two types based on the movement of heated molecules: natural convection and mechanical convection. In natural convection, the movement of molecule is natural without any external force. As we explained in this example, the pan is heated through conduction and the same heat is transferred to water molecules. The water at the bottom becomes hot through conduction, the hot water becomes lighter and move upward, and the cold and denser water at the top come down and thus water gets heated. This process continues and develops a circulating current which evenly distributes the heat throughout the substance. This happens due to natural convection. On the contrary, if we stir the water in the pan, we are using an external force to circulate the heat. So this is called mechanical convection. In another example, in convection ovens, pan or exhaust system blow hot air over and around the food. Mechanical convection shortens the cooking time and cooks more evenly. Unlike conduction and convection, radiation method of heat transfer doesn't require any contact between the heat source and the object to be heated. Heat is transferred due to energy waves emitted by another object in the form of electromagnetic radiation. For example, when we stood outside, we feel the heat of sun, even though we are not touching it. So heat can be transmitted without any medium, even through empty space. In cooking, we usually follow two types of electromagnetic forms, infrared radiation and microwave. Infrared radiation uses an electric or ceramic heating element that emits infrared radiation. These radiation or waves moves in all directions at the speed of light. When these radiation absorbed by food surface, the molecules receiving infrared radiations are agitated and start vibrating at high speeds, which creates friction and generates heat directly within the food. For cooking by infrared energy, various sources are available, such as the oldest or traditional way of cooking in villages. A bed of coal from hardwood or charcoal emits high infrared energy from combustion. In the oven, broilers are superheated until it emits infrared energy. A broiler is the heating element in an oven. You must have seen small countertop appliances which keeps the food warm. Even many small room heaters uses quartz as a heating element, which requires very little electricity to generate infrared energy. Even many toasters also use a quartz heating element. Next is microwave radiation. Microwave radiation causes water molecules of food to vibrate that create friction between molecules, which results in heat. Due to its short and high frequency waves, it penetrates deeper and cooks faster than infrared radiation. In a microwave, you should not use any conductive material such as a metal. You can use plastic, glass, and ceramic plates to cook food as their water content is very low, which makes these less prone to heating. But keep in mind that microwave works best for cooking small batches of food. Do note that as microwave works on water molecules and the human body has more than 60% of water, so it could affect your body tissues similarly as food. So do not use broken or damaged microwave oven. Now let's understand all three forms of heat transfer from a simple example. Take some combustible material such as wood or coal, then burn it. Place a pan of water over it. Now the heat is transferred to pan through conduction, as it is in direct contact with heat source. The water molecules catch heat energy from pan, start creating a current through convection. Once the lower water molecules are heated, then they become lighter and goes up. Denser and cooler molecules which are on the top take their places at bottom, and this process continues and water gets heated. When you are around the heat source, you must have felt some heat. That's because of the radiation transmitted in the form of waves or rays or particles. Well, I hope your concept of heat transfer is clear. Knowing the different forms of heat transfer can help you better understand the science of cooking and improve your skills as a professional chef. If you like the video, do hit like button. For any doubt or suggestion, comment down below. And don't forget to subscribe Hospitality Broadcast. Thank you for watching.